A very special welcome to students and those viewing from home. I am Megan, along with Nick, Jack and Ellen. We will be your hosts for this year's 3-4 presentation day. 2020 has been a year to remember and the world is now a different place. Among the difficulties and hardships, school has always proven to be a safe and happy place. Today is a chance for us to celebrate the highlights of 2020 and to share in its many success stories. Lily Cruz will now acknowledge the traditional owners of the land where this meeting is taking place.
Penania Public School is built on a land belonging to the Darug people, the traditional custodians, the caretakers of this land. This land also borders the lands of the Darawal people. The Darug were peaceful people who lived comfortably and used the land and resources with both care and ingenuity. The Darug language is still alive today and many descendants of the Darug nation live in the local area. We pay our respects to the elders both past and present and also the Gandagara Aboriginal Land Council who are the current caretakers of this land. Please stand for the national anthem which will be sung by a 3-6 choir.
I would now like to introduce Penania Public School's principal, Mrs. Shavak, to address the assembly.
Thank you. Good morning, students, parents, carers, staff, and guests watching remotely. Today, we're provided with an opportunity to acknowledge students that have shined throughout the course of this year. Their efforts and admirable qualities need to be showcased as brilliant examples for other students to follow. Last year, at this time, I spoke about the power of positive growth mindset and about embracing the school's learner qualities to persist with challenges, even when something seems really hard. With continued effort and practice, you will get better at the tasks that challenge you. Do you remember how we talked about how Walt Disney, he was rejected 302 times before he got approval for finance to build Disneyland. He was even fired from his job because he wasn't thought to be creative enough. We talked about Harry Potter, how Harry Potter was also rejected 12 times by 12 different publishers until American Scholastic decided to take them up on their offer and take a chance on a new author. Even my favourite Dr. Seuss, his very first book, was rejected by 27 publishers. Imagine if he didn't persist. Imagine if he didn't keep going. And even the face of modern physics, Albert Einstein, he couldn't even speak until he was four and read until he was seven, but he persisted. But this year, 2020 has been an extraordinary year. It's been filled with challenge. It's pushed everyone, students, parents, staff, outside of their comfort zone. It's been filled with complexity, where we had to think creatively and think about how to problem solve situations we find ourselves in. It's been filled with change. Change can make you feel uncomfortable, but it also can be an opportunity to grow. And obviously, it's been filled with uncertainty. Sometimes we haven't been able to plan for weeks ahead, for the next term, because we just didn't know what was around the corner. We've even had to consider how to do things differently, because this year, it's not only been the year of resilience and adaptability, but it's also provided some surprising opportunities. As a community, we've all had to make daily adjustments to everyday lives and think in novel ways. Our students had to grapple with the concept of remote learning and learn to connect with family and friends in alternative ways. This year, drive-by birthdays and Zoom parties have been the norm. Even our teachers at school, it's been a year of prototyping for them. Rapid testing and harnessing skills and resources, often from unexpected means. Notably, throughout the year, not one single student complained about the changes made to routines, activities and school processes. They humbly accepted that sporting activities, excursions, camps, dance, choir, debating and discos, among many items, had to be cancelled, postponed, modified, put on hold. Assigned gates and play areas provided extra levels of complexity and at times confusion. However, throughout this intense period, you, the students, have remained well-humoured, optimistic and open-minded. In fact, levels of innovation have soared, providing opportunities for students to lead and influence. Students across grades have come to me and to other teachers with ideas and plans that have been welcomed and wholeheartedly supported. They came armed with proposals, taking on feedback. They evaluated their plans and made adjustments accordingly. This has included writing competitions, drawing competitions, book clubs, Save the Ocean Club, 60 Seconds of Fame, touch footy, handball tournament, Wizards and Magic group, and even a loom band group. The focus was not on the end process, but on the thinking that involved in the first place. I'm incredibly proud of these efforts, as these thinkers are going to shape and reshape the future. Now, this level of adaptability is needed in our ever-changing world. So take, for example, Blockbuster. Now, mums and dads and grandparents, they would remember going down to the local Blockbuster store on a Friday or a Saturday night to hire a movie and watch it at home. Now, the founders of Netflix, Reed Hastings and Mark Randolph, they knew things needed to change. They knew that people wanted movies not just for one night. They wanted them at home, at their fingertips, whenever they wanted. They wanted movies on demand. And so they decided to change things. They decided to be adaptable. They started to mail DVDs and videos out to people. And by 2000, they had a great business doing incredibly well. And they offered to sell it to Netflix for $50 million. To Blockbuster for $50 million. At the time, Blockbuster was worth $6 billion. Blockbuster saw no need to change. And by 2010, they declared bankruptcy. Bad move, Blockbuster. Netflix went on to streaming by 2007, and is now worth $194 billion. Because they chose to be adaptable, they chose to stick to the change and make some differences. All of us would also be familiar with the Barbie doll. Well, one day, Ruth Handler in the US, she was watching her little girl play with paper-based dolls and paper-based clothing. And she thought to herself, there must be a better way of playing with dolls and dressing them up. So she was inspired to come up with a 3D version. And that's where Barbie originated from. And she called Barbie after her daughter, Barbara. Now, this idea wasn't popular at first. She took it to the New York Toy Fair in 1959, and it wasn't well received. People didn't like the idea, but she persevered. Now, Ruth Handler, the original person that came up with Barbie, she actually went on to become the co-founder of Mattel Toys. And now, Barbie is an international icon. Another example would be Alexander Graham Bell. He invented the first telephone in 1876. He thought this was a great idea. He could transmit voice. He wanted to sell it to Western Union for $100,000. At the time, Western Union was the big one in communications, and they were using the telegraph. They didn't see the need for change. They didn't want to be adaptable. They didn't take him up on his offer. So Graham Bell went on to make lots and lots of money. But possibly my favourite example of all time would have to be Lego. Lego was introduced back in 1932, but the original Lego were wooden toys, not the little plastic bricks that you've become accustomed to. It wasn't until 1939 that the founder took a chance in purchasing a large plastic moulding machine to produce Lego bricks. And by 1955, the Lego system of play was born. Even by 2001, the company was in trouble. It was losing money and losing popularity. It needed to change to adapt to new markets. It adopted the spreads methodology, where people from different departments would stop everything for a week and work on a common task to prototype new ideas. This goes to show that change, adaptability, and innovation is needed at every level of society, whether it's online shopping, Uber Eats, or home delivery services. So today we assemble to officially acknowledge our award winners, but I would like to officially declare 2020 as the year of adaptability, resilience, and change. I extend a huge thank you to our adaptable students, staff, parents, and carers that have kept our community safe, informed, and connected, demonstrating courage and collaboration. Adaptability opens your mind to new ideas, makes you question how things are done, and gives you the willingness to go against convention. Adaptable people are not scared of change, as they will seek out opportunities and put in place measures to succeed. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Shavak. This year, teachers have nominated 6 students for class awards. A 7th student will receive a Commonwealth Parliamentary Distinguished Merit Award. This award is designed to be presented to students who have achieved distinguished merit in either leadership, academic results, arts, or the community. Our first awards will be announced by Ms. Skinner, the coordinator of Stage 2.
Our first awards are for 3D and will be presented by Ms. Ecob. Bentley Campbell, Most Improved. Tiffany Robinson, Class Citizenship. Lexi Rari, Outstanding Academic Achievement. Gabe Matthews, Outstanding and Consistent Effort. Rowan Assad, Enthusiastic Effort and Application. Timothy Swibble, Sports Award. And Archie Tawney, the Commonwealth Parliamentary Distinguished Merit Award. Please congratulate the award winners for 3D. The award winners for 3H will be presented by Miss Howe. Isaac Kamensky, Academic Achievement. Ruby Pringle, Enthusiastic Effort and Application. Oliver Chem, Consistent Application in All Areas. Julia Fan, Consistent Effort and Academic Achievement. Madeline Nee, Consistent Conscientious Effort. Simon Campbell, Sports Award. And Christian Lassessen, Commonwealth Parliamentary Distinguished Merit Award. Please congratulate the award winners for 3H. The awards for 3N will be presented by Mr. Newman. Lily Brown, Consistent Effort and Application. Carla Dell, Outstanding Academic Achievement. Georgia McKeesh, Most Improved. Chloe Hunter, Enthusiastic Effort and Application. Cullen James, Consistent Conscientious Effort. Cooper Witham, Sports Award. And Marley Fulliger, Commonwealth Parliamentary Distinguished Merit Award. Please congratulate the award winners.
Students from kindergarten to year two have thoroughly enjoyed being part of their dance group and again show us how talented our students are. They wish to thank Ms. Morris and Ms. King who choreographed and taught them this dance. We hope you enjoy. High five, ready or not.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Thank you to the Cater 2 dance group. We now come to our Year 4 awards, which will be announced by Ms. Skinner, coordinator of Stage 2.
The awards for 4SM will be presented by Mrs. Schering. Georgia Bocek, consistent, conscientious effort. Mia Kondos, outstanding application and academic achievement. Annabelle Clayson, academic achievement. Scarlett Wooldridge, consistent application and achievement. Eli Gibson, enthusiastic attitude and application to learning. Khan Met, sports award. And Jack Tetley, Commonwealth Parliamentary Distinguished Merit Award. Please congratulate the award winners from 4SM. The awards for 4AW will be presented by Mrs. Walker. Lily O'Donovan, Most Improved. Genevieve Chanceska, Academic Achievement in Writing. Sebastian Kreske, Academic Achievement in Mathematics. Sophia Leolius, Class Citizenship. Sky Newman, Consistent Application and Achievement. Curtis Marsh, Sports Award. And Lucy Tran, the Commonwealth Parliamentary Distinguished Merit Award. Please congratulate the award winners for 4AW.
These awards will be presented by Ms. Skinner. The first award goes to Curtis Whitehall for outstanding application and academic achievement. Emily Dunson for class citizenship. Arabella Howe for conscientious effort. Oliver Maxwell for academic achievement. Finn O'Donovan for Most Improved. Tom Barton for Sports Award. And Indiana Cook for the Commonwealth Parliamentary Distinguished Merit Award. Please congratulate the award winners for 4 minutes.
The 3-6 choir, under the guidance of Mrs. Walker and Mr. Dodd, have been busily rehearsing for their performance. Today they are singing for us, How Far I'll Go.
Staring at the edge of the water, long as I can remember, never really. could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water, no matter how hard I try.
Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the light, the stars, the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes.
Mrs. Apostolovsky will now announce the 2021 student leaders.
An important part of our previous Stage 3 assembly this morning was the investiture of Panania Public School student leaders for 2021. And I'd like to just let you know who our prefects are, followed by our vice-captains and then our captains for 2021. Firstly, our prefects are Andrew Makroglu, Alex Solomon, John Samoulis, Kayla Pargovsky, Ava Pringle and Isabella Savides. Our vice-captains for 2021, Hadley James and Tristan Crines. And our school captains for 2021 are Miller Fulliger and Jackson Vajewski. We'll give them a round of applause in their absence.
This last slide acknowledges the families who, along with their children, are leaving our school. We wish you all the well for 2021 and beyond. Thank you to everyone who has attended or viewed today's presentation. Your ongoing support of the school and your appreciation of the students' efforts here today is greatly valued. Our thanks must also go to the teaching and non-teaching staff of the school who have put in so much effort into making this day and the entire 2020 school year such a great success. Thank you again for attending today to celebrate another wonderful year at Panania Public School.